Here in Hampton Roads, we see the effects of sea level rise every time we get so much as a hard rain. Roads become impassable, water creeps into homes, and cars get stranded in floodwater. Brilliant minds and countless dollars have gone into solving the problem, but so far that has all come up short. So why not see what some eighth graders in Portsmouth can do about it? Our Lex Gray has the story.
I'm on the news for a good reason, for a good reason. This is for camp.
As you can see, Chandler Thompson's got charisma, but his teachers are also banking that he's got comprehension and creativity.
Another egret over there flying.
Just because they're children, that doesn't mean that they can't solve problems or give us solutions to environmental concerns.
Davina Williams works for Portsmouth Public Schools and helps run Camp Answer, where STEM students are focused on learning about sea level rise.
They're definitely passionate about it because it's their community, and they know that it's something that they're going to end up solving. They're going to solve a problem for where they live.
Thompson says he's missed school because of flooding, and camp helped him see that consequences could become even more severe.
It hit me like, wow, at first. Then I was like, oh, so that's probably what was behind big issues like with Katrina and New Orleans.
Thompson and other campers will learn from Williams and fellow teacher Tiffany Nichols, as well as experts from local businesses and the Department of Forestry.
They can become these ambassadors for our city, for our district, so that they can go out and share what they've learned about our ecosystem and about coastal flooding.
At the end of camp, kids will present their ideas to city council. And Williams and Nichols say council members should be ready to be wowed.
That would match our science department against any district.
Lex Gray, 10 on your side.
Did you see that look? If you missed it, go to wavy.com and you can look again, because that's confidence. Campers will present their pitches to city council this Thursday morning. We'll post a link with some of the highlights on wavy.com.